One morning, I wake up and I find the headmaster, my father, and a few teachers, and they just said, we've discovered what you're up to, and that's it, you're gone.
One of the reasons that kids are engaging in hacking is because it's challenging, it's fun.
Now you can shut down an entire hospital like we saw on the East Coast with ransomware.
These kids that are hackers today, they really do, in the truest sense, have the ability to make or break our world. Oh boy, yeah, script kiddies. What's a script kiddie? God, that's an old term.
Script kiddie is somebody who wants to accomplish, you know, some sort of malicious activity, whether it be, you know, breaking into a system or stealing credentials.
Basically, a script kiddie is somebody who doesn't necessarily understand the exploits or the techniques of hacking, and is relying on scripts or programs that were created by somebody else. So they're taking a script, they're running the script, they might set it to run against a particular target, but they don't necessarily understand how the technology works, and they don't have the skills to make them their own.
My way of getting into hacking was very different from the normal way, which is experimenting with cheats and then getting into hacking. I was about 12 years old, and basically what happened was that one day a friend online who I chatted with was like, I found a really interesting little program and I want to try it out. He put my telephone number into this account and he was able to take over my whole WhatsApp. I mean, completely take over my WhatsApp account. He was able to write messages to all of my friends and say all this stupid stuff. It's a technique where you're able to completely take over and control an account that's not yours. I was like, how have you managed to do this? And he said he couldn't tell me that, and it had to do with software he's got. So from that day onwards, I started to get interested in hacking.
Script kiddies have had a resurgence in the last like 5 or 6 years. And that is due to the increased sophistication in cybercrime, that there is more ransomware. And this is an easy way for people to make easy money.
Oh boy, this is a great time to be a script kiddie because there is so much information out there.
Script kiddies are having a repurpose.
That is because of the proliferation of hacking tools, and not just the proliferation, but the accessibility of the tools, and as well as their autonomy.
If you're a kid and you want to create as much havoc as possible from your room, you have tutorials, you have YouTube videos, you have entire Linux distributions that contain all of these penetration testing or hacking tools.
So this tool is fully autonomous, and what it is, it's basically a network slash penetration testing framework. It can be thought of like a Swiss Army knife. It can brute force all open services. It doesn't require a whole lot of user input.
Script kiddies, by their nature, though, don't necessarily have the technical understanding or even the curiosity to develop exploits. However, even a stop clock is right twice a day, right? They might get lucky, they might figure something out on their own.
So even though if you don't know how to do these things on your own, you would use an autonomous script to run these things for you. And the end result, I mean, is what you would hope.
But really, you know, when you look at script kiddies, it's just a group of people who use a tool that point and click and have no idea what goes on behind the scene.
Nowadays, it is more of a derogative term for people who lack knowledge at all.
I saw this stuff as kind of a prank, but if I think about it now, even if it's quite light and simple, it can be very dangerous. Like, if you're able to just have someone's telephone number without any two-factor authentication and take over their account completely, it's incredible. You could enter into the profile of a politician or some celebrity and just wreak havoc.
When kids are engaging in hacking behavior, there is a little bit of an empathy gap here, and wanting to be different, wanting to individuate themselves, wanting to entertain people, including themselves as well as their friends, by doing something, you know, something naughty or unexpected.
When I did the attacks on the school, I was about 14 years old. I was using Python. because I wasn't very good yet at writing viruses. So I was copying and pasting snippets of code from online sources, and I would create scripts that way which could bypass antivirus programs. Basically, code that I was writing would take over the computer and allow you to install and delete files, turn on and off the webcam, to record using the microphone, steal passwords, everything.
The hacks now are more encompassing because we have more connected technology. You know, you have refrigerators, fish tanks, heating systems. So back in before the internet, we didn't have HVACs connected to the internet. Now you can shut down an entire hospital like we saw on the East Coast with ransomware. So the attacks and the lethalness of the attacks are getting worse.
The first time the data caught me hacking was when I had stolen a large amount of private data from my school. I started to post it online. It caused a lot of problems and they caught me. They expelled me. One morning, I wake up and I find a headmaster, my father, and a few teachers. And they just said, we've discovered what you've been doing, and that's it, you're gone.
A script kiddie or someone who is not very skilled would leave a lot more traces on who actually did the attack. And you could see traces of failures and maybe dead ends during the operation.
These kids that are hackers today, they really do, in the truest sense, have the ability to make or break our world. And we have to make absolutely sure that we are both nurturing them and nourishing them in the right way.
I don't think taking a kid who has committed, you know, a white-collar crime on a computer and throwing him in prison is the right answer, when we can take that kid who probably doesn't even know the laws around, you know, cyber, teach him the laws, redirect his attention, and make him a successful industry-leading, you know, man or woman.
I consider myself a great hacker. I do stupid stuff, but underneath it all, I'm a good guy. I mean, my goal is to make maybe a little bit more money, to go out with my friends in the evening and maybe grab a pizza, general stuff. I'm somewhere in the middle between a skiddie and a hacker. For the time being, I'm just a kid messing about, making a nuisance of myself. Nothing more than that.
I do think that there is more of an influx of script kiddies today. People that are 15, 16 years old, getting into Kali Linux, trying to figure out how these systems work, how do these tools operate. This influx of script kiddies is perhaps part of a natural evolution of the profession. What the script kiddies are today may be our cybersecurity professionals tomorrow.